very insightful presentations, some great ideas, really, some very innovative ideas. And I really hope that many of you, you know, who feel so passionate about these ideas that you have conceptualized today, you know, would move forward with these ideas and essentially plan to implement them, you know, in some way. What we have got today, I think, is a good start and a good foundation, you know, to develop these into compelling business propositions. And I'm sure, you know, there's a lot more detail that needs to be fleshed out. There is a lot more work that needs to be done. There is a lot more, you know, research and consultation that, you know, you would need to do, you know, to implement these. But I would really say that, you know, if you would do that, it would really be worth the effort. I also understand that, you know, when we join a business school, or even before we join a business school, the first priority, the first objective, you know, for all of us is to make sure that at the end of, you know, our 2 years, we all have, you know, a nice job, you know, with a multinational organization, you know, hopefully based outside, you know, of India, or if not, you know, with in a good position, you know, in a country for ourselves. And very few of us, you know, would really look for starting up our own businesses, our own ventures. But I think the 2 years that we spend over here gives us, you know, that invaluable time, and probably time that would never come back, you know, in our lifetimes, to really think of, you know, some of these ideas and areas of innovation from things that you see around you, from the lectures that you attend, from the various research papers, you know, that you would do, mm-hmm. and really craft out, you know, a niche for yourself that, you know, you may want to develop, you know, as a business proposition and pursue that, you know, in your lives. I must say that I was very, very impressed by all the presentations that were made. However, I would just like, you know, to share a couple of ideas, a couple of points, you know, with you to probably keep in mind, you know, while you present, you know, your research papers or any such presentations, you know, in future. And certainly don't take this as a criticism, you know, by any means, but certainly, but just as a piece of advice, you know, from someone who is still in the industry, you know, a little more, you know, than what you have. The first point that I would like to say, you know, which I saw almost consistently in all the slides, you know, was, and even, you know, in the slides of the group that would eventually be, you know, the winner of today's competition, is that, you know, you have too much text, you know, on your slides. And what I think, before I say any further, I must say that, you know, when I was, you know, one amongst you, you know, in my business school, I did the same. I have learned it the hard way, and I would like you to get over it as quickly as you can. Don't try and have, you know, your slides as your speaker notes, where everything that you ought to say in front of your audience, you know, should be there on the slides. The slides are just intended to capture the key points that you need to convey, and probably are just helping agents for you to describe the point and describe the concept that you have in mind. The rest of the content, you know, has to come, you know, from you, and you should not even, you know, be feeling the need to look at the slides, you know, too often, you know, for referring to your content. So if you would do that, you know, that would be, you know, something very good. What we, you know, at Ernst & Young feel that every slide that, you know, we present should be fully understood, you know, by the audience in less than 30 seconds. So if you use that, you know, fundamental principle, and I don't think Ernst & Young, you know, invented it, but it's just that we follow it, you know, very regularly. But if you would, after preparing anything, if you would feel that, if I look at it as a member of the audience, and if I'm not able to understand the contents of the slide in 30 seconds, there's something that I need to do about it. The second thing, you know, that I felt was that in a lot of cases, the main ideas, you know, were essentially, you know, stuck up towards the end of the presentation. When you stand up to present, you would have the maximum amount of attention of your audience, you know, in the first 3 or 4 minutes. If you are not able to retain that attention, it would fall down immediately. And you would find it very difficult, you know, to get that attention back from your audience unless, you know, you start off with a song and dance sequence or something like that. It's extremely important then to make sure that whatever your key message is, whatever your key idea is, like in today's presentation, you know, that we are talking about that one innovative idea or a set of ideas. So whatever that one idea or that set of ideas is, make sure it comes through in the first couple of slides, and then you take us, you know, through the details of what is the background, what is the context of the industry, what are the issues, what are the challenges that it's facing. A lot of you, you know, had did financial analysis, you know, as well, which was very good to see. So all these details, you know, can come, you know, subsequently, but the main point has to come up front. Those are, you know, just a few random pieces of thought that I thought would be worth, you know, sharing with you and might help you, you know, in your, not just in your future academic presentations over here, but also, you know, in future, in your future careers. So, thanks again, you know, for your time and attention.